We learned about different crystallographic conventions, for instance, on the choice of a unit cell. And there are also crystallographic conventions which govern the positions in the Hermann-Magellan symbols of point groups. So, in the triclinic crystal system, with no symmetry or just inversion symmetry center, we have no conventions on positional order. But, for instance, in the monoclinic crystal system, the symbol in the Hermann-Magellan notation denotes a special direction of the B cell constant, or in the second setting, the C cell constant. In the orthorhombic crystal system, the three symbols correspond to the A, B, C directions respectively. In the tetragonal crystal system, the first symbol corresponds to the special direction of the C cell constant. And the second symbol, if present, corresponds to the A direction. The third symbol corresponds to the crystallographic direction 1, 1, 0. So, for instance, in the symbol 4 over m, mm, the first part, 4 over m, corresponds to the direction C. So the fourfold symmetry axis is parallel to the C direction, and the perpendicular M symmetry plane is perpendicular to that direction. Then the second mirror symmetry plane is perpendicular to the A direction, and the third symbol, also M, is a mirror symmetry plane perpendicular to the crystallographic direction 1, 1, 0. In the trigonal crystal system, the first symbol corresponds to the special direction C, and the second symbol, if present, corresponds to the direction A. The third symbol corresponds to the crystallographic direction 2, 1, 0. In the hexagonal crystal system, we have the same convention. The first symbol is along the C cell constant, the second symbol along the A cell constant, the third symbol along the crystallographic direction 2, 1, 0. In the cubic crystal system, the highest symmetry crystal system, the first symbol corresponds to the C direction, and this is usually twofold or fourfold symmetry axis. The second symbol corresponds to the 1, 1, 1 crystallographic direction, and this is a body diagonal of the cube. And in this case, it's always a threefold symmetry axis. The third symbol, if present, corresponds to the crystallographic direction 1, 1, 0. As a reminder, I show you also on the slide some symmetry elements of the cube. Crystal structure contains simple and translational symmetry elements. A symmetry group of the three-dimensional structure motif is the so-called space group. In case of space groups, we combine the Brave lattices with point symmetry groups and the symmetry elements with translations, so the screw axis and glide planes. It can be demonstrated by means of the group theory that there are exactly 230 space group types possible in the three-dimensional space. And these concepts, again, can be generalized into higher dimensions. In principle, each crystallographer closed in a prison with pencil and supply of paper and given enough amount of time should be able to derive the diagrams of all 230 space group types. And these space group types were derived in 19th century before any experimental evidence of the internal structure of crystals was available. And this was done independently in three countries by Schönflies, Fyodorov and Barlow. We have to realize that we often say space group but in reality we mean space group type. There are 230 space group types, but space group is a result of decoration of a space group type with specific structure motif. So if we consider that there is an infinite amount of structure motifs, there is an infinite amount of space groups as well. We'll also use Hermann Magaon notation for space group types. And in this notation, as shown at the bottom of the slide, the first symbol corresponds to the Brahe lattice centering. For the symbols on the slide, this is the primitive centering P. The second part corresponds to point group symmetry. And this can be one, like in the first example, P1 space group type. But we can also have substitution of some point symmetry elements with translational symmetry elements, like on the second example. There we have 2-1 over C, which means that in the point symmetry symbol 2 over M, the twofold symmetry axis was substituted with twofold screw axis, and the perpendicular mirror symmetry plane was substituted with the C-type glide plane. In the international tables for X-ray crystallography, volume A, for each space group type we have one chapter. And each chapter comprises at least two pages. I will show you what information is available on these pages. And I suggest that you also refer to an extract from the International Tables for X-ray Crystallography provided in this course as a separate PDF file. So let's start with a simple space group type, P1 BART, the triclinic space group type. So we have here a Hermann Magaon symbol, P1 BART. We have the corresponding Schoenflies symbol. We have a full symbol. In this case, it's the same as the normal symbol because there are no secondary symmetry elements generated. We have the corresponding point symmetry group symbol and the crystal system, in this case, triclinic. Then we have diagrams which visualize where the symmetry elements are located. And these diagrams are plotted at different orientations. These orientations are summarized, in this case, on the pictures, but they are also subject to some conventions, and they are described at the beginning of the International Tables, Volume A. There is an origin point marked on these diagrams, and there is a symmetry center, which is denoted as a small ring. You can refer to the slide where I showed to you the symbols for different symmetry elements used in the International Tables for X-ray Crystallography. Let's highlight one of these diagrams. There is one diagram which shows what happens when the diagram is decorated with specific structure motif. So we have a ring, a bigger ring, which denotes atom or molecule in arbitrary position in this space group type. If there is a little plus next to this symbol, this means that the atom is over the paper plane. If there is a little minus, it means that this atom is below the paper plane. And there is also a ring with a comma inside, and this means that this is a mirror image of the original atom. So these two circles, one with comma and without comma, with a plus and with a minus, are related by a symmetry center in this space group type. As a result, pure enantiomers cannot crystallize in this space group type. As a reminder, enantiomer is a molecule which cannot overlap with its mirror image. And the different enantiomers of the same compound could have completely different properties. For instance, the etheric oil limonene has different smell depending on the enantiomer. So one enantiomer has a smell of orange and the other one of lemon. Further, we have information about the choice of the origin in this space group type. In this case, it's a symmetry center, and this is a typical case, but this could be also the highest symmetry point. Then we have a list of symmetry operations in this space group type. In this case, it's just identity and the symmetry center. Further, we have a list of symmetry elements which are generators of this space group type. Then we have a list of types of positions in this space group type, the so-called Wyckoff positions. This notation comes from mineralogy. And they are assigned the so-called Wyckoff letters useful for their description. There are two types of such positions, general positions, which means on no symmetry element, and special positions on a symmetry element. In this case, it can be only an inversion center. And if a molecule lies exactly on special position, it has to adopt its symmetry. For instance, here, this would be an inversion center. So we would say that the molecule adopts crystallographic symmetry of inversion center. There is also a number assigned to each of these positions, the so-called multiplicity. Here, for the general position, the multiplicity is 2. And multiplicity parameter shows how many atoms are generated by symmetry if a single atom is placed at that position. The multiplicity is smaller for a special position, in this case, 1. Then we also have some information about systematic absences of reflections on the X-ray diffraction pattern, but this information will be described more in detail in the second part of the course. And at the end, we also have some information about the relations of the space group type with respect to other space group types. This is particularly useful in description of structural phase transitions when the structure changes abruptly in solid state. And there are two types of such relations. The subgroups are formed as a result of elimination of certain symmetry operations, whereas supergroups are a result of addition of certain symmetry operations.